The pack of fallen had followed the dropship out into the wilderness. The FOTC officer that had come along with them voiced his concerns and fears upon seeing them, but all the while, as the officer asked what should be done, the Titan was silent, as if lost in prayer and contemplation. He readied his weapon, coursing with electricity, and began his hymn.
They risk quiet on fields afar, for this is not the storm, but the eye.
This is Thunderlord, an exotic heavy machine gun found in Destiny. The weapon itself is legendary, not simply for its experimental induction core that feeds lightning into every single round it fires, but also for the fact that every Guardian that has wielded it has created legend. For every round that this weapon fires is another word in the hymn of the Thunderlord, and the Guardians that wield it are the songs of that hymn. The hymn itself will carry on, even when the Guardian cannot. Whilst all heavy machine guns in the Crucible are truly a force to be reckoned with, Thunderlord surpasses them all. The weapon itself holds a high-caliber machine gun to ransom with incredible power. Weapons such as the Swarm and Yolda's Hammer can stand up and compare, but perks such as Feeding Frenzy, which increase the reload speed of the weapon after kills are obtained, and Lightning Rounds, which mean that targets will occasionally explode with the AoE electricity running through the weapon, and the weapon will fire more accurately and longer when the trigger is held, enforce the idea that Thunderlord truly is the king of these weapon types. Other heavy machine guns are not capable of such incredible outputs of damage, and the weapon is truly fearsome for these reasons. However, the other perks that come with the weapon are also excellent. For those favoring accuracy, there is Perfect Balance, which increases the stability of the weapon. For those favoring a long, drawn-out fight, Field Scout will bring your ammunition capacity from 38 up to 60, and Flared Magwell increases response time by allowing you to reload even faster. However, two of these upgrades are more useful than one of them, and Flared Magwell loses out. Meanwhile, Field Scout and Perfect Balance are approximately equal choices. Both of them are usable, but neither of them are perfect, by any stretch of the imagination. For your ballistic options, you have several choices. Firstly, Accurized Ballistics is probably one of the best options you'll get to start with on any exotic. The stability is the highest on this, and also the range is well balanced, not to mention the recoil curve is moderate. However, Field Choke, the next option down, decreases the stability significantly by over 10%, and finally, increases the range by 2%, not a worthy upgrade, not to mention the much harsher recoil curve. Next, however, we have Linear Compensator, an interesting choice. It still decreases the stability by quite a margin, but at the same time, when one considers the fact that the recoil is more controllable, it's an option that some might want to take. However, keep in mind that when using this weapon, it's not always consistent. However, one thing that is consistent is the number of shots it will take you to kill an opponent. It will always be 4 shots, regardless of whether you hit all 4 weapon rounds to the head or all 4 weapon rounds to the chest. The weapon will always kill in the same number. This is not necessarily a terrible trait for a heavy machine gun to have either, seeing as they don't always manage to reward consistent accuracy. Thunderlord, however, will accommodate it. An adjusted 1.5 optical zoom scope will allow you to put rounds on target. The fact that it's a packed pair of TrueSight IESs is not necessarily a terrible point either, as it's one of the clearer scopes that you can find in the heavy machine gun category. However, the rate of fire is what is truly most fearsome about this weapon. The weapon starts at a standard 346 rounds per minute. However, due to the Lightning Rounds perk, it will amp up first after the first 20 rounds to 460 rounds per minute, and then after the 40th to 642. This becomes gradually more uncontrollable, although it is capable of reaching out further. Despite this, the lack of stability that you find during the weapon's higher fire rates is most certainly something that restricts it to the mid-range, and the weapon is already excellent at locking down corridors, so why change this? The magazine capacity is also something that helps with this trait. 38 rounds is perfect for holding down a location, and Field Scout brings that up to 60, which encourages the idea that you can create a much longer, more drawn-out engagement with a weapon such as the Thunderlord. These engagements more often than not end up being wins, but they also do require some patience. When it comes to using Thunderlord in your general playstyle, appreciate the fact that all heavy machine guns, especially Thunderlord, work best in the mid-ranges. You can take this weapon and you should be gunning down auto rifle, fusion rifle, and pulse rifle players on a regular basis. However, when you take this weapon and start to attack enemies in CQC areas, you'll lose out to shotguns, attack them in long range areas, and you'll lose out to snipers and scout rifles. Take also into account the fact that mid-range styles work well with the Thunderlord. Use zone control builds on Warlocks, or use the Ward of Dawn as a zone control tool on a Titan in order to lock down an area of play and seal the map. Make sure that you control everything over a high traffic choke point that allows you to see enemies on a regular basis. Stop the enemy from reaching positions. Make yourself an unbreachable wall. For these very reasons of both zone control and of controlling the rest of the map behind you, I recommend the Defender Titan for this. And in particular, a zone control based mid-range build that uses weapons of light as a support tactic for both you and your teammates' benefit. Use this in order to lock down the areas of the map more effectively. Use the Ward of Dawn like a wall. Place it down and ensure that you can find everything that comes your way. Click the annotation on screen in order to see the build. All things considered, Thunderlord has excellent traits for any heavy machine gun. The reload bonuses are excellent, the explosive damage perk is somewhat frequent, and the higher rate of fire when reaching lightning round's peak can be useful when taking on masses of enemies, making it akin to the damage of a rocket launcher. However, the poor stability and magazine capacity can occasionally hamper your longevity, and sometimes there is the problem of the fact that the weapon is not necessarily worth the exotic slot. It's difficult to see how taking Thunderlord into account as an exotic is necessarily a bad thing because of the fact that it is an exotic, but this is something that most players wish to avoid. Others believe that legendary heavy machine guns simply fit their playstyle better and allow them to use other weapons. However, they neglect one simple truth. They are not going to be part of the hymn of the Thunderlord, for every single verse speaks of the legend of a guardian that wielded it. For they have all found it in the wilds, earned it through combat and glory, and every one of them is truly legend. You are the one who now writes this prayer, the hymn of the Thunderlord, for it is not something that is written by the pen, this is written by the sword. Mighty as it is, the hymn of the Thunderlord stands at the foot of the one who writes it. You now hold the pen, you wield the sword. What legend will you write, Guardian?
This fight's over.
Thanks for watching. Remember to leave a comment and a like. For those of you who wish to vote on the next exotic weapon guide, click either of the two annotations above for Thorn or Bad Juju. My name has been Bife. Paradasia Astra. I'll see you starside.